Good morning, I'm Bill Griffith. This is part three of my series. In this video, we'll talk about the basic materials you're going to need to start having fun, relaxing, and creating in painting. Although I prefer oil paints at this time, I will also cover some of the basic materials you're going to need if you want to explore watercolor and acrylics. To begin with, we got to talk about painting surfaces. What are you going to paint on? I mean, there's paintings showing up on walls of buildings and everywhere else that paint on brick, board, you name it. But what do you need to start off with? A couple basic things. If you're going to start with watercolor, simply pick you up, and they're available at any of the vendors, such as Hobby Lobby, Amazon, Michaels. I don't sponsor any of them, but I've used them all. And you can pick you up a little pad that basically has paper specifically designed for watercolors. And if you read the label real good, it says watercolor on there. You can use this for watercolors and acrylics. And they're really handy when you go down to the beach and you want to start painting something. And that's basically what I did in this, and it allows you to do sketches on vacation or wherever you happen to be. And if you really enjoy the masterpiece when it's done, you can take it out and frame it. It's really handy. Like I said, that works for watercolors and acrylics. Now, acrylics can also be used on the same canvases that you can use for oil painting. And they come in a lot of different varieties. One of the most common, cheap method is basically the canvas that's already on cardboard. They come in various sizes. They're available a lot of time on sales. And you can pick you up a package and practice, and they're not real expensive. So if you don't like them, you can toss them or whatever. They're very handy and they're lightweight. And you can get bigger, but I wouldn't go too big with them because they do tend to warp a little bit and don't seem to last as long in a frame over years, that type of thing. Example of that, and this is an acrylic painting, is basically acrylics have beautiful colors. They just tend to dry too fast for me, so I prefer oils. But it's just basic landscape, put a little antelope in there. And like I said, this is this canvas is 10 by 20. It's a small canvas and probably $2 or $3. But it depends on whether they're on sale, that kind of thing. So those are handy. But you can also move into cheaper canvases, stretch canvas. And again, they're available at the same vendor. Typically, they're on some sort of wood frame. And the cheaper is a canvas that's been prepared with a gesso so that the paint adheres better. You can use this for not only acrylics, but also oils. So they work out real good. And you can get bigger ones and fancier ones. You know, they come in various thicknesses and that type of thing. Now, once you progress, you might want to move on to stretching your own linen, coming up with your own frames. And as I said, they're already prepped with gesso, but you can add more gesso. I mean, it's available. So just paint the gesso on and go from there. So you keep moving, and the gesso prep is basically you can put several layers on there and smooth them out and kind of prep your canvas, maybe a little better looking when it's done. So that's prepping. Now, going from there, you start talking about paint. Obviously, painting, if you're in watercolor, I've used simple little paint kits from, you know, various resources that you would buy for children in elementary school or something. They work fine. I mean, they've got good colors. And they're definitely something that you can explore with. You can get fancier if you want to. One of the things as you go up is acrylics, which is also water base. They come up with fancy little kits, and these are handy when you go down to the beach or something and you want to do sketches. And they have various paints in there. They have the brushes and the little mixing balls. And again, the medium is a water just like watercolor. And you can paint away on the same little booklet that I showed you, or on a canvas. Now, you notice these tubes are small, so they don't last long. So typically what you want to do after you get a little further into painting is go to a bigger tube, and that's basically gumball, or this is gambling here, and bigger tubes, and they last long. But if you get into it like I have, where you really enjoy painting, you'll go through a lot of pain. And so just explore, try different things. Now, the next thing you got to do is, how do you put it on canvas? And that's your brushes. Now, lots of different types of brushes. You can go on any of the vendors or go in the store, and you'll just get buried with all kinds of things. But typically, to start, to kind of get going, is this gets you 3 or 4 different type of brushes of different width. They make them in a kind of a manufactured fiber, which is nylon or something that they've come up with. Long stem, that's typically so that you're a little freer as you get started, and we'll demonstrate all that. You can also get a more animal fiber type thing, and it could be sable or some other foam. And actually, you can make your own brushes if you really get energetic later. Now, all that said, big brushes is typically what you're going to use. One of the big fallacies is, for somebody beginning to paint, is they immediately try to get too much detail. And so we're going to do a lot of this with big brushes. Now, once you've tried to get details, you may want to go to the smaller brushes, and that's for eyelashes and eyes and stuff like that. And these you will hold like this. It's almost like a ballpoint pen, and we'll demonstrate that. Get you one or two of those. So you don't need a lot of brushes to start with. You'll definitely start adding pretty fast, and we'll go from there. Now, that said, is mediums. Most oil paints are mixed with linseed oil. And so to thin them, you'll use linseed oil is probably the best, but it takes a long time to dry. So some people want to speed up the drying time a little bit by using Camsol. So I would suggest get both, get a small bottle of both, and just explore it and see what you got. It does take, like I said, several days for oil paints to dry. And it's actually, the linseed oil is what they use within the tube itself to thin the paint, so very compatible. Now, clean up, watercolor acrylic is just water. Just clean it up with water. Keep your brushes clean. For oil painting, you can use a terpentoid or turpentine or mineral spirit, something like that. Or I really think the best thing is just to go and get you some dish soap and hot water and scrub them out and clean them up. And they tend to last a lot longer that way. Now notice, I think I jumped through this, but I'll go back to it, the long handle here. Again, these are basically held way down here, and we'll demonstrate that. They're not held like this. This is for the little detail brushes later. So we'll play with that too. Now, once you get through the brushes, you gotta clean it all up. We've talked about that, water or terpenoid, which is actually turpentine, but it's safer for you to use, and hot water and soap. Now, if you like this video and appreciate it, I'd really love for you to hit the like button and subscribe, because I will be coming back with more. Again, this is a very simplistic type program, but if you want more detail, you can use my email. I'd be more than glad to respond to it. It is in the subscript subtitles. In earlier videos I go through, in fact, in video 2, I talk about my email address. So hope to see you again. Thanks for watching, and have a blessed day.